The continued advancement of game engines has made it easier to create high-quality backgrounds using light and shadow. However, creating a wonderful space requires a lot of preparation. There is the convenience of being able to do everything with one click, but this requires a lot of knowledge. In this lesson, we will learn about the global illumination data creation process. In this video, we will cover real-time GI. This process can vary from person to person, so if you have a better way than mine, please let me know in the comments. Since we already have real-time GI data in our sample scene, let's clear the GI data by pressing the Clear Bake Data button in the Lighting tab. Now this background only has brightness and darkness due to directional light. We need to select directional light and make sure that the mode option is selected as real-time. Now we need to select all the background elements and make sure the static and contribute GI options are turned on. In particular, GI calculation and data generation will not occur if the contribute GI option is turned off. I created separate groups for shadow handling and collision management. You can see that the closed room has no light at all. To block the directional light, I used a cube that can be created in Unity. If you set the mesh renderer's cast shadows option to shadow only, the cube's surface will not be drawn and only shadows will be generated. This has the advantage of allowing for both collision area and shadow generation to be implemented simultaneously. Areas that do not require shadows, only use box collision to avoid any performance degradation. For complete darkness in enclosed rooms, I disabled environment reflection in the shader. I will explain why I do this later. You must create at least one light probe group for every moving object to access Bake GI data. One of the new features in Unity 6, the adaptive light probe, only works in a mixed light environment. So, you need to make sure that the light probe system option in the render pipeline asset is selected as light probe group. Now let's generate real-time GI data. We need to make sure real-time global illumination is turned on in the lighting tab. As mentioned before, we will not be using mixed lighting. More detailed options for generating real-time GI data will be covered in the next video. In this video, we will proceed with all options set to default. Once baking is complete, you can see that the textures have been created. Even though each texture is small in size, the quality of the lighting and shadows applied to the stage is very high. As you change the angle of the directional light, you can see the intensity of the reflected light and ambient occlusion created on the walls and floor change. You can also control the intensity of the reflected light by changing the indirect multiplier. Changing this setting is only possible when GI data is available. As you adjust the HDR intensity of the shader, you can see the brightness of the surroundings change. This adjustment is only possible when the game is not running. Also, Please note that you cannot change the brightness of the surroundings while the game is running. I currently have the environment reflections option enabled on the walls and floors inside the building. This reflected light is the color of the skybox. Places where environmental reflection should be active are usually outdoors. However, in enclosed spaces there should be no environmental reflection. Therefore, materials for indoor and outdoor use must be prepared separately. For this purpose, I recommend using material variant. What about custom shaders? For the lit shader, environment reflection is built in by default, but you need to use a separate keyword to disable it. Simply add the bool keyword environment reflections underscore off. This keyword is a reserved keyword, so adding it will work immediately. The standard, lit, and simple lit shaders provided with Unity are ready to accept GI data. However, custom shaders require extra work to receive and utilize GI information. The Bake GI node provided by Shader Graph allows GI information to be used in shaders. Simply blend the Bake GI node with the final color of the shader. Since no external light enters the room, no shadows are created on the character. Additionally, no real-time lighting was used indoors at all. There are no shadows where the character is standing, so it feels very unrealistic. I used SSAO to solve this problem. Because the room isn't very bright, there's no need for sharp shadows. SSAO can be less accurate in certain situations, so it's best to avoid excessive settings.